Good evening, Patriot fans. Welcome to Homewood Football. Tonight we come from you to you with from historic Legion Field, where the Homewood Patriots, 14-0, ranked number one, take on the Buckhorn Bucks, who are 13-1 out of Madison County in North Alabama. And last week we had a tremendous game against Benjamin Russell Wildcats, where the Patriots won 24-17. And we're going to go right to our Jim and Nick's Players of the Week last week. And we appreciate Jim and Nick's for bringing us the best players of last weekend's game. And we're going to go right to the defense with Jody Brandt.
Well, thank you, Tim. On defense, it's number 87, Dominic Porter. Had a great game last week. 12 total tackles, 7 solo, 5 assists. Had a huge quarterback sack for a safety and pressured quarterback 3 times. For the year, 76 tackles for Dominique, 6 quarterback sacks, multiple pressures, just a leader. And Tim, thanks for Jim and Nick's for the food before the game.
Yeah, we appreciate Jim and Nick's and all they do for Homewood football. And there's a great shot of the Patriot cheerleaders on the field, and we're fixing to get the starting lineups for the Homewood Patriots right here. See if we can zoom in on our starters for tonight as they will be introduced here at Legion Field. Here they're coming up, the Homewood Patriots, and on the loudspeaker. There's Dominique Porter, number 87, just got through talking about him. Cordarius Rogers, number 68, the fine defensive tackle. And Robert Gentry, number 50, one of the fabulous front four. And there's Aaron Sackfield, and what a great year he's had. Number 51, Stan Galbraith, the all-time leading tackler in Homewood history. Senior David Green, number 41, middle linebacker. DJ Taylor, number 34, outside linebacker. And Michael Oliver, the senior safety, number 6. Number 26, Scott Lee, the senior cornerback. Daniel Hayes, senior safety. Number 5, Kenny Baker, the junior. And there's Will Cole, wide receiver for the Patriots of the offense. Number 3, superstar Tim Hawthorne, number 3. Number 32, Tyler Robbins, the speedster junior. 82, Wilson Boardman, the senior tight end. And then there's this All-State offensive tackle, number 75, David Ross. Number 57, Jarvis King, the junior offensive guard. And there's Bodine, the senior center. Daniel Mathengani, number 73, the offensive guard, senior. Michael Thompson, another senior tackle for the Patriots. There's the double deuce. Number 22, Steve Freeman, senior tailback. And the senior leader of this Patriot squad, number 12, Austin Hubbard, and there the Patriots come onto the field. And what an exciting time this is for these young men, Larry and Jody. But let's go right back to the offensive player, Jim and Nick's last week, Larry.
Number 3, Tim Hawthorne, 11 catches, 140 yards, had a touchdown, and also a two-point conversion. Another super game for Tim Hawthorne. And, of course, everybody knows he holds all the records, single season and career, in every category of receiving. So congratulations, Tim Hawthorne, on a great game last week and being Jim and Nick's Player of the Week, but also on a terrific career.
Yeah, we want to thank Jim and Nick's one more time, and what a great supporter they are of Homewood football and Homewood in general. Larry and Jody, what an experience this is to play out here at Legion Field in the state championship game. I know we've been here 5 out of the last 6, but it never gets – it's still a huge game.
Yeah, and this is the most anticipated for me, guys. This is a special group. Fix to see them take the field. 33 seniors. What a fabulous group of young men. Tribute to them, their parents. And let's just watch this and remember this. Historic group of young men right here, Larry.
I tell you, what a senior class. The best we've ever had, the biggest we've ever had. And there are our captains out there in the center of the field. And help us out there, Tim.
There's our captains tonight. Stan Galbraith, 51, 46. Aaron Feld, Tim Hawthorne, number 3. And number 22, Steve Freeman, and what four great fine seniors they are and captains. But there's a great shot of all the other seniors right there, 33 of them. And what a special group they is. And there's the most special, number 11, the head master and captain of this bunch, Brad Wilson.
Unbelievable that he's even able to physically dress out tonight. Don't know if he'll take the field, but just him being out there has got to be an inspirational lift to the team, guys. And here we go.
Big moment, and congratulations, Brad, for getting back in uniform after a big injury like that.
What a great bunch of guys, young men they are, and a lot of these guys have a lot of Homewood High School records, and you're looking at 51, Stan Galbraith with a leading tackler in Homewood history. Aaron Feld has set the record on sacks at 18, and we got one more game to play. Tim Hawthorne with all the receiving records in Homewood history, and then, of course, Austin Hubbard with all the passing records in Homewood history.
Well, you're right, and all those guys have those records, and Steve Freeman is in the top category of the rushers. Only Davis, who was Mr. Football back in 1991 and really 1990 also, and, of course, Brandon Thornton. So he's with the top three all-time tailbacks, and that's quite an honor to be having your name, you know, called out with Thornton and Robert Davis.
Absolutely. And five of those young men played on the varsity as freshmen, which is unusual in Homewood. And these guys are going to play their last game.
You're right. The Fab Five, as we called them back way back in the day, what, 4 years ago or 3 years ago, when they were freshmen. And, of course, they're leaders on this team. But this is an exciting time, guys. We're fixing to kick them off.
Huge crowd, guys. I know we're in Legion Field, but huge crowd. I've got to think, 10,000 total, both them and their side, and people coming in, seeing coaches from the past, people that live outside Homewood now. Everybody's here. Everybody's excited. So we're in our lucky red, Tim, so let's bring it home.
The Patriots will be kicking off tonight, so our defense will be on the field, and what a great group they are. They really swarm to the ball. And, you know, we got a lot of things that are the Buckhorn Bucks have never played in the championship game, but the coaches are from the same city, and that's amazing.
Well, you're right. They both played at Russell, our coach Bob Newton and their coach. But, you know, what you said, this is our first time to ever play Buckhorn and their first time to ever be in a championship game, and I got a feeling they're either going to come out sky high or they're going to mess up right off the bat. I don't think there'll be any middle ground. So let's see how it comes out. We're going to kick off to them.
Well, I feel real good, Tim and Larry, because Coach Newton has that jacket on that has been mighty special for him and all Homewood. So here we go.
He won it in our second state championship win in 1995.
That's right, and he's worn it every championship game since. That's his lucky jacket, and he's not going to break that tradition.
Well, we talked about all the records of the individuals, but this team can set some – other records that Homewood teams have never done. We've never won back-to-back state championships, and we've never been 15-0.
You're right. This is the first time to ever have a chance at. Well, we had a chance in 2001 and didn't make it. We got knocked off. We were 14-0. But maybe this crew right here can do it. So, and also, if they win, they will tie the record for most wins by a senior class at 41. So a lot riding on this game for these seniors. But nothing bigger than the state championship.
The Patriots on a 19-game win streak. So we're going for number 20 here in the state championship game of 2005. Daniel Hayes, the senior kicker, safety for the Patriots, will kick off. Our kickoff team, 48, Mike Stonewall, 43. Brandon Mara, 6. Michael Oliver, high, short kick. Fair catch at the 25, where the Bucks will have it, first down and 10.
Effective kick by Daniel Hayes. Got that sky kick figured out. Been doing it the last half of the year. And let's go defense. I'm ready for that front four to set the tone, Larry.
Yeah, that's excellent. If we can keep them starting from the 26-yard line every time, that's a plus.
There's a great shot of the red jerseys and the defense right off the bat. So the Bucks are out of their huddle from the sideline. Big front for the Bucks. Spread out, one guy in the backfield. Everybody spread. There's motion, there's a fake keeper by the quarterback, and number 51, Stan Galbraith, with the tackle.
Well, guys, I think that's a sign of things to come. They are not used to the speed of Homewood's defense. Nobody is. Stand the man Galbraith coming unblocked. You can forget getting by him solo.
That's an appropriate way to start a game with your career leading tackler, all-time record man makes a tackle. Way to go, Stan.
A lot of hype this week in the paper about the Patriots. Motion, another keeper. Aaron Fell gets a hand on him. Corderas, David Green, all in there on the second play.
Like a broken book, a broken record. Watch what this. Everybody's in. Aaron Feld slows him up. David Green gets in. Corderas slams him down. Love it.
They're running behind big number 61, who's about 6'7", 6'8", and about 330. And Robert Gentry went right around him, and the guy didn't even get a glove on Gentry.
So the Patriots on defense, 3rd and 7. Give to the tailback, and number 50 meets him in the hole. And it'll be 4th down.
I wish I could get a picture of that, guys. Total defensive domination. All 11 guys in on the tackle. Could be a long night for Buckhorn. Let's hope so.
Well, look at Robert Gentry. Way to manhandle a big guy. And this is North Alabama football where you run until you can't run. Then they'll throw it. But they're definitely testing that out. A wind-up kicker here. He's very slow getting it off.
So the Patriots have 10 up. Looks like we're going for the block. Tyler Robbins back at the 41. He gets it off, and it's a good one. Robbins back at the 39, and a nice tackle. Patriots will have it 1st down and 10 at the 38.
31-yard punt that time, and lost about one. And Tyler getting up a little bit slow, but I believe he's going to be all right.
Nice tackle by the sprinter for the Bucks. Patriots will have it 1st down and 10. Ball's at the 38.
Let's get off to a quick start here, guys. We've been a little slow motion getting going the first last couple of games.
Ladarius Woods going to start for Robbins. Straight drop. We're going to run the screen to Freeman. Ball's tipped and tipped again into Freeman's hands. And he gains about 7 on 1st down.
Well, I'd rather be lucky than good any day. And let's watch this again because we tipped the ball, they tipped the ball, and he comes over. It's a great play by Steve. But it's a little bit of luck involved there, and I'll tell you what, nice play and a good reaction by Steve Freeman.
Impressed by the size of Buckhorn's defense, guys. They're the monsters.
2nd down and 3. Ball's at the 44. Motion by Cole. Rolling toward Hawthorn. Caught at midfield and a 1st down. For the Patriots, first down at midfield.
Nice pitch, nice catch, beautiful blocking out front here. Let's watch this again. One of the big things is they're known for all their sacks, and we're known for not giving any up and no pressure whatsoever. Good job, offensive line, nice pitch and catch.
Ball spotted at the 49. There's All-State receiver Tim Hawthorne, number 3. Trips to the far side, Hawthorne to the near side. Straight give to Freeman with a big hole again. About 9 on 1st down.
Big blocking up front, physical football, out of way to go, Patriots. Let's watch this again, and Steve Freeman does an outstanding job.
Offensive line pushing them back, Larry, winning the battle of the trenches here.
The offensive line, Bodine, Daniel Mathengani, Jarvis King, David Ross, and Michael Thompson. Trips to the far side, Hawthorne to the near side. Rolling toward Hawthorne, throwing the quick out, and another 1st down for the Patriots.
Well, again, no pressure whatsoever. Nice pitch, nice catch, and bread and butter Homewood football.
O-line keeping them out. Watch this replay here. Watch David Ross and Bodine and the boys. Look at that. All day. I think I could even throw that one, Larry. Maybe not.
Yeah, but they completed it.
Well, that's not what they said at Sherbrooke Circle. So cleared backfield for Hubbard. Motion by Woods. There's a looking for the Utah to Woods, and they blow that one up.
53 is an outstanding player for Buckhorn, and I think they had that one read, and that was just a nice play by them. But that's all right, 2nd down and about 11, so let's go.
If they get excited about a one-yard game, hey, good for them, because that was still not a bad play.
So a loss of 1, 2nd down and 11 for the Patriots. We're going to run the reverse to Woods. We got one guy to get by. Woods gets by him. There is a flag on the play. going to be holding on the far side.
Ticky-tacky, ticky-tacky, oi, oi, oi.
Well, there's two things that can hurt us here tonight, and both of them are us, but one's turnovers and others penalties. And here comes the first penalty here as a holding penalty on about the 36. It's going to take it back to the 46. It's going to be second down and about 19 yards.
Good block, though, by Austin Hubbard and David Ross. They just creamed some guy over there at 77, I think.
But, well,
here we go.
The official, Mitch's favorites group, the officials are from all over the state. They're a split crew, and there's the holding call. And the ball will be spotted at the 46-yard line. Second and 19 for the Patriots.
The people doing the live TV broadcast have a camera on wheels behind our bench, and that's what just rolled in front of our camera.
Double receivers each side. Rolling toward the right. Hubbard looking and throwing. Hawthorne in the middle. He got about 18.
Lots of time. Austin does a great job picking out the open man and right down there about a yard and a half short of the first down stick. But beautiful play. Look at that time. And the man has come all the way across and not enough to get there. And he picks the open man. And what a rifle shot. Beautiful reception.
What a great throw and a great catch. Third down and about two. Ball's at the 29-yard line.
Well, we got a timeout, an official timeout. Let's wait and see.
I think we're trying to get the clock set or something. Get the play clock going, I think. There you go. Third down and two for the Patriots. Trips to the far side. Boardman at tight end back to the near side. Straight give to Freeman. He's got the first inside to the 24.
Vintage Freeman, a little contact up around the line of scrimmage, no problem. He picks up about five.
Look at that O-line blocking up front. Bodine blew him out. Boardman, look at that. 59.
There are the Hogs up front. What a great year they've had. What a tremendous offensive line the Patriots have. Trips to the near side. Boardman to the backside. The tight end going to fake. Looking for Cole. He catches it. And about the seven.
What a fake. Everybody thought Freeman had it, including me, especially me. And he's got the ball. Austin, like always, controlling that ball. What beautiful ball handling. He hides it. And everybody turns to watch Freeman. A rifle shot downfield and a beautiful reception there.
Ball spotted just outside the six. First and goal to go. Freeman. Gain of about two or three down to the four.
Off tackle, hard running there, guys. North and south. Steve cut it up in there. Here's a replay. Taking it right behind Ross and King, I believe, Larry.
How about Michael Thompson over there? Beautiful block. Hooks that man out there. Good job, Michael Thompson.
Double tight end set for the Patriots, and there is a flag on the play.
Somebody's offsides here. Please don't be us, because that'd be big on us and small on them.
Well, guys, there's good news. Tyler Robbins back in the game after getting his ankle checked out, and he's back in the game. So the Patriots move here, so we're going to back us up five.
Turnovers and penalties. That's what we got to dodge here tonight. That's our second penalty. We've got to work through it and keep this drive going.
Second down, goal to goal. The ball's at the eight. Double receivers each side. Austin rolling to the near side. Sits down, throws in, corner pass to Will Cole, the senior, for a touchdown.
Wow, what a beautiful route. Will Cole always getting behind them, gets in front of them this time. And boy, does Austin deliver this football. Watch this again. Beautiful blocking up front. Steve Freeman picks up the blitz and outside linebacker. But Austin rifles it in there to a wide open Will Cole. Great job, guys.
Austin Hubbard on the money once again.
Ninth TD on the year for Will Cole. Nine touchdowns.
Aaron Fell, will you snap? Scott Lee, will you hold? Daniel Hayes, will you kick? And it is good. So 6:19 to play here in the first quarter. The Patriots up 7-0.
I've never seen anybody have nine touchdowns and 21 receptions. The guy scores almost all the time. It's ridiculous. Let's watch this again.
Get that replay, Glenn.
Great shot of the kicking team. And we're going to go into the touchdown right here.
Watch this. Austin Hubbard, record breaker, record setter all day. Will Cole makes it look so easy. Congratulations.
So the Patriots go 10 plays, 62 yards in 3 minutes and 57 seconds with an 8-yard touchdown pass from Hubbard to Cole. We got a timeout on the field. Let's see if we can take a timeout with Malcolm Otto.
I must say that in all my years, I have never seen such a pitiful display. The word disappointing doesn't quite describe the performance we see here tonight. The resources were available, but they didn't get the job done.
Okay, that's enough.
Look, I told you not to take it to one of those quick lube places. Now we're all late for the game. This one's all over, folks. I can see the fat lady warming up now.
Appreciate Malcolm Otto, Robbie Malcolm, 871-7111 there in the curve in Central Avenue. And Robbie's with us up here in the crowd tonight. I saw him earlier. He's never missed a championship game in Homewood history. All the way back to 74, made the ride in from Aniana tonight. And appreciate Malcolm Otto.
You know, for a guy that's 35 years old, that's a pretty good record. Speaking of records, every time Austin completes one, he's breaking his own record. And he was only 7 for 7 on that drive. Is Austin Hubbard on fire?
26 touchdown, guys. 26. Unbelievable, Austin Hubbard. Let's go. Kickoff coverage. Oh, it's Hurricane. Get down here. Make
something
happen.
So our kickoff coverage team for the Patriots, number 40, Michael Causey. DJ Taylor, 34. Kenny Baker, 5. Stan Galbraith, 51, 26, Scott Lee, 81, Cortez Slaughter, number 47, Kenneth Dorsey, 48, Mike Stonewall, 43, Brandon Clark, and number 6, Michael Oliver. There's a thrill of a lifetime. You got a good shot of Will Cole and Coach Gann on the jumbotron here at Legion Field. Hayes on the high short kick. But fair catch at the 23-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 for the Bucks.
Well, talk about an effective kicking game, guys. No return, and we got them pinned back right where we want them. And another three and out coming up, I predict, guys.
Yeah, great shot of Daniel there, and a terrific kick. And we were proud of the 26 last time. Now we got them on the 23.
60 of 65 extra points for Daniel. 7-10 on the year on field goals. He's become quite a proficient kicker.
Gentry and Rogers, your two tackles. Hand straight off Robert Gentry at the 25.
Buckhorn, the Bucks have never seen the likes of us, guys. Speed and strength slanting right into the run. And look at that hit. Unbelievable.
Robert Gentry demolishes the guard and then goes and demolishes the ball carrier. Way to go, Robert Gentry.
Robert Gentry, Cordarius Rogers in at tackle. Dominique Porter, Aaron Feld in at the end. DJ Taylor, David Green, Stan Galbraith. Second and 8. Give right up the middle, and there's a pile of Patriots there.
Tim, you just chalked that one up to a defensive tackle because the whole unit was there. D-line's clogging it up, linebacker's there, and everybody gets the ball. Even the free safety gets his hand on the stack.
David Green in on the tackle. Your two cornerbacks are Scott Lee, Kenny Baker, the lone junior, number 5. Your two safeties, Michael Oliver, along with Daniel Hayes. 3rd down and 7 for the Bucks. Straight give, and there's a big play by number 50, Robert Gentry, and Aaron Feld, number 46.
You add those two up, Tim, you get 96, and I think they made 96% of the tackles on the line. Watch those two guys. Unbelievable.
Boy,
senior play.
Almost fooled both of them, but in the meantime, they, you know, 1 yard gain.
4th down and 6. A quick kick. He got it out of there. It's going to be short, take a hop, and it's going to roll down to the 34 where the Patriots will have it first down and 10.
40-yard punt, no return, but the Patriots are in pretty good position here. Our own 34, let's go offense. And what a great two performances right there by our defense.
There's a great shot of Matt Reebles. Had a nice article on him and his dad, uncles, and his brother today in today's Birmingham News.
You know, the whole Reebles family, that was a great article, and no family's contributed more football players to the Homewood team. We got a timeout here. Let's take a timeout with them.
Timeout. Let's talk about our friends, Colonial Bank.
Connections. Life has many. Putting you in touch with a pretty remarkable world. At Colonial Bank, you'll find the Colonial Connection. A connection to banking the way you want it. Not just a direct link to all the conveniences that banking has to offer. It's your connection to something even more important. Our people. Your financial needs. Our people. That's the Colonial Connection.
Colonial Bank. We can do.
Appreciate our friends at Colonial Bank. There's a great shot of the senior quarterback, number 12, Austin Hubbard. Touchdown, Will Cole, along with the double deuce, as Jody likes to call him. Steve Freeman, great three seniors right there.
Tell you what, with 32 or three seniors on this squad, what a great group of kids, and not just good football players, but wonderful young men.
They are, Larry, and again, I always say this, but let's give credit to their parents. That's a good, strong group of parent leaderships. They have been since they've been freshmen, and cheerleaders there. Everybody's involved.
Yeah, I tell you, there's another fine bunch, and did an outstanding job. Had a wonderful pep rally today, and, you know, I didn't know Coach Newton was on the balance beam or whatever it was there today. But
something about him taking a flip and
playing dodgeball, weren't
they? He's made it on all the news channels, and something about knocking a girl out with a dodgeball right between the eyes. But,
hey, you play to win, don't you?
That's right, baby.
There's a shot of the little Santa Claus man on the 21-yard line, and that's the guy that's holding up the game. It's a TV timeout. As long as he's out there, they're going to hold up the game, and the TV, you know, money dictates the story.
Ho, ho, ho.
There you go.
So a TV timeout here, and not something you're not used to in high school football.
How did Mitch get out on the field so quick with that hat?
Yeah, and that guy, I don't think that's Mitch because he doesn't look old enough. What a wonderful crowd here tonight. I think there's more than 10,000. There may be 12 or 15.
Yeah, there's Daphne Trojans are in on the same side down at the north end zone. Pike County right down in front after winning a state championship yesterday. First down and 10 for the Patriots, looking for Boardman in between, and the ball goes incomplete.
Good idea, and he was open, just did not quite connect, and we'll try that one again a little later, I'm sure.
Wide open, and I think Austin wanted him to run a little bit further. He was wide open. Sometimes you get so open, you lose the ball. And in a big stadium like this, Larry, that ball tends to float on you a little bit.
That's a tough play for their safety. He's got to come a long way. He got there right at the last second. So the Patriots with a second and 10. Trips to the near side. Boardman to the far side. Keeper by Hubbard. He's going to get a couple.
That's one of those keep him honest plays, Larry. I don't think it was meant to get a big game, but just keep him honest.
Buckhorn has two fine defensive tackles. Big old 77 and little 53 is so fast and quick. So they're the two most aggressive players, along with their middle linebacker and 18 backer, the big 6'4 man that may come in and play a little offense.
Third down, eight balls. At the 36, Hubbard rolling to the far side, looking. Ross with a pancake. Caught by Hawthorne and a first down.
Another catch by Hawthorne, and we're going to get 15 more, guys. Let's watch a late flag coming in. It has to be on Buckhorn.
Watch this replay. Blocking key. David Ross takes that super defensive lineman just creams him, Larry. A great throwing catch. And the, you know, chip, you gotta catch the chips in, go to Hubbard to Hawthorne every time.
Face mask after the catch. Matt Rebels with a huge block. Let's see, Glenn, let's see if we can roll that one more time. Watch the block by Matt Rebels, the pulling guard out here.
That was just a 5-yard penalty, but let's watch this block.
Well, Rebels runs his guy all the way to the sideline. 5-yard penalty, balls at the 47. Give to Freeman in a big hole. He's going. Touchdown for Steve Freeman. 47 yards untouched.
Double deuce. That's all I'm saying. Double deuce. Take it to the house, baby.
Woo! And a run, Steve Freeman, and what a hole up the middle. You're playing touch football. Nobody touches
him. Watch him duck his head, turn it on. Watch it right there.
He knows he's open. He ducks that head down and says, I'm giving it all I got. And that was enough, big man. Way to go, Steve Freeman.
Thank those big offensive linemen up front, guys. They blew that hole open big time. Watch the extra point here.
Hayes on the attempt. Scott Lee with your hole. Aaron Fell with a nice snap. Good kick. And it is true, and the Patriots out 14-0, 3:22 in the first quarter. Wow.
Let's see that one more time if you got it, Glenn. This is highlight. I'll watch this when I'm eating my dessert there at the banquet.
That's the play before that got us to the 47. What a great job by the offensive front. We're going to try it one, see if we can get as much as we can out of this thing.
Tell you what, I can't watch that play too many times. Here he comes. Look at the line just tearing them up. And big Daniel Mathagani turns them and seals off the inside. But Steve Freeman, buddy, you can outrun them all. Way to go, big man.
So in a minute and 8 seconds, the Patriots score. Go four plays, 66 yards, 47-yard touchdown run for Steve Freeman.
Here we go, guys. My favorite play, kickoff coverage. Something big is going to happen. I predict a sky kick, Larry.
Something big has already happened, man. I mean, this is a lightning bolt. 3:22 to go in the first quarter. Patriots up 14-0. Defense perfect, offense perfect.
Hayes on the kick once again. High kick, a little longer this time. Ball's coming at the 15. They're going to return it. He gets to the side, and he's got a lane. Daniel Hayes with a tackle.
That's why you keep your lanes, Larry. You got to keep your lanes. Play contain when he had somebody fall down. But that's okay. Way to go, Daniel Hayes.
Oliver slips and gets a good lane up the sideline. Daniel Hayes with a big tackle.
I don't think I've ever seen that before where you have two guys outside waiting on him, and they both, I don't know if they got knocked down or slipped down, but beautiful return by Buckhorn. And if they're going to get some life and get back in the game, this is it.
I think that green spray-on paint on the field they slipped on, Larry.
Sam Berry, the junior, in it, middle linebacker. Good field position right at midfield for the Bucks. Straight give. Got a little running room. He's going to gain about five. Sam Berry, along with Michael Oliver, all on the tackle.
Big Sam Berry, 42. Slipping over there, making a good linebacker play. See if we can see that one more time. Man, next time we'll get him. But Sam Berry, good. Kept his outside shoulder free. Made that tackle.
So gain of 5 yards, second and five. Split backs, shotgun formation for the Bucks. There's a straight give up to the middle. Dominique Porter, Robert Gentry, and Aaron Fell all in there.
Dominique Porter.
Jim and Nick's player of the game last week, big play. Larry, we're just too fast for him. Too fast, too strong. Cordarius did a good job.
The Dominator, I tell you what, he did that one right there. Good job, Dominique.
We talked about it many, many times the last few weeks. There's not many better than those front four we got on defense that I've seen all year long.
Yeah, we've all three agreed on that all year long. That is the best front four. Got another timeout on the field here.
There is a timeout on the field. Let's take a timeout, Limbaugh Toyota.
Toyota one stop. One stop is all it takes to get Birmingham's best savings on Toyotas. Because Limbaugh Toyota keeps overhead low, we can sell the Uptown collection of Toyotas at bargain basement prices. The Toyota you want has never been more affordable. So visit Limbaugh Toyota today, just 5 minutes from downtown at exit 120 on I-59. Or shop online at limbaughtoyota.com. We'll even deliver your Toyota right to your door. Limbaugh Toyota. One stop says it all.
Appreciate Bruce and Debbie Limbaugh, Limbaugh Toyota. Go see them, and let's go and see our starting lineup of our cheerleaders. Lacey Mann, senior captain. Mallory Watson, senior co-captain. Heather Morgan, senior. Haley Dyke, senior. Caitlin Creed, senior. Meredith Stinson, a senior. Sarah Funderburk, a senior. Brooke Lorino, a junior. Christina Gillespie, a junior. Jasmine Hoskins, a junior. Stephanie Irwin, a junior. Cameron Laster, a junior. It's back to live action right quick. Big play for the Bucks to try to stay in the game. Third down and five. And a straight give. He gets to the outside. Scott Lee with a big hit.
Sherbrooke circle style, baby. Way to go, Scott Lee. Stop him short of the first down. Big hit.
Nice play, Scott Lee. You think he's got the first down pretty well made. He gets outside, and there's that 40. And all of a sudden, Scott Lee is there. Good play, Scott Lee.
DJ Taylor along with Michael Oliver. So they feel like they got to go for it here. Fourth down and one. Minute and 30 and counting here in the first quarter. Patriots up 14-0. The Bucks with their backs against the wall. Fourth and one. Straight give. Hey, he got the first down. Aaron failed.
Tim, Larry, they had numbers on it that time. They did a full set over there. They had two more guys than we did. So we need to stop them right here.
Yeah, let's see if we can finish our cheerleaders right quick. Keegan Ballinger, a junior. Brandy Lewis, junior. Quincy Marlin, a junior. And Finney Giatina, a junior. Of course, they're headed up by Maggie Stauffergen and Ms. Hare. What a great job.
And Ms. Drake.
And Holly Ms. Drake. All of them are out here. And we appreciate all they do. And they've had a busy week preparing for the state championship game here tonight. First down and 10. Ball's at the 39. Gain of about three or four on first down.
Big hit. Quick hitter up the middle. DJ Taylor in there. Robert Gentry. Who else in there? Stan the man. Last one getting up. There he is. Good shot of Stan.
Kenneth Dorsey, number 47 in the game for the Patriots.
They all got number 11 on their biceps.
Second down and a long six. Straight give. Not much there. Except DJ Taylor, Stan Galbraith.
Cordarius Rogers.
I mean, it's like they caught him like a breadbasket tackle. Guy ran right, boom, right into his hands. Stunted right into him. Big stop. Another timeout, guys.
End of the quarter. That's the end of the first quarter.
So that's the end of your first quarter here with the Patriots up 14-0. And let's take another break here at the quarter and talk about our friends out at Porter Tire Service. There's a good shot of the sign at Porter Tire. They have all makes and brands of tires. Front end alignment, wheel balancing, brake work, any type of work you need to work on your car, go see Eddie Porter at Porter Tire Service out on Bessemer Superhighway. There's a good shot of Eddie. Appreciate Eddie. There it is, Porter Tire, 1215 Bessemer Road, 925-4488, Porter Tire Service.
Tim and Jody, we've played 15 first quarters this year, and the score after all 15 is Homewood is 182, and the opponents are 8. Count them to 8 points all year. That's unbelievable.
Unbelievable, and the second quarter stats are just as impressive, so let's see if we keep it up.
I've never seen a team that could hold 15 opponents to 8 points in 15 games. That's pretty impressive.
That is very impressive, and you talk about it.
At the end of the first quarter, Homewood has 140 yards of offense, 70 rushing, 70 passes with six first downs. Buckhorn ended the first half on 12 carries for 24 yards and one first down. Big half a foot, quarter of football for the Patriots.
There's a good friend down there, David Cutcliffe, and the defensive coordinator at Tennessee. What's his name?
Cutcliffe?
Never heard of him.
The defense
coordinator.
Chavis and Cutcliffe are here.
Of course they're on the Homewood side.
Thought I smelled something. But here we go.
So fixing to start the second quarter. The Bucks only have one first down. No points here in the first quarter. See if our defense can.
Total domination by our Patriots. And this is just everything you could hope for and more, actually.
Good shot of the defense, guys. Coach Sheets down there with him, my old defensive coach, helping out this year. Coach Wright, Kelvis. I'll take that 11 anywhere in the country, Larry. I don't care who we play.
So it's third down and about six for the Bucks. I'm not sure what that is. Stan's got something on his forearm. We'll try to figure out what that is. So a straight drop, they throw it. Kenny Baker with great coverage. Michael Oliver, friend, number 18, comes up, makes a huge play.
When 18 comes in the game, they're going to throw to him. He's 6'4", and that's what they do, throw it up for grabs and let him out-jump our shorter cornerbacks, and that's not his first time to do that all year.
Good play on their behalf. Give credit where credit's due. Just had the physical talents to out-jump us, and let's see if they get this extra point.
So the Bucks strike, first play of the second quarter.
There you go. What a goal, Kenny.
Kenny Baker makes up with a big block.
Great effort, great speed, coming off the corner. I had a feeling that was going to happen, Larry. Been close all year.
I'll tell you what. Speed with desire, and that's a lethal weapon right there. Number five got both, and a terrific job, Kenny Baker.
Yeah, just so the audience knows, we do have the offensive and defense coordinators from Tennessee here watching the game tonight beside us, and that's quite a tribute to this team as well.
Well, you know, Larry, you were talking about our defense, and, you know, we got a tremendous offense, most powerful offense, and statistically in Homewood history once again, and you know, what a great job they do.
You're right. They're averaging more points per game than any team that's ever we've ever had in 34 years. They have already gained more yards than any other team. And so you're right. Best offense we've ever had.
Good.
Well, we
good.
Talk a lot about our players and what they've done. But, you know, the biggest thing, we have tremendous coaches, and we'll go more and more on that as we go. There's Coach Gilchrist from the middle school. You got Russell Martin. They're talking with his defensive backs. Kelvis White with his back to us.
Get
of course,
your
Mike Clements is up
there, Glenn,
in the.
We're about ready to kick it off.
Mike Clements back up in the press box. And of course, the defensive coordinator, Dickie Rye. What a tremendous job they do. So the Bucks are on the kick. Woods and Hawthorne back at about the 10. Got to kick it high and short. Robbins at about the 20. Coming this way, got a lot of red in front of me. Found the seam. He's out to the midfield.
There you go.
Where the Patriots will have it first down and 10.
What ankle injury, Larry. He came right back strong, strong north and south running. Where'd it go, man?
This guy can run kicks, and he had a lot of help from the red shirts. Look at all the blocks coming, and the wall was really set up. Beautiful block there by Boardman. Boardman has a nice
Boardman.
One.
Yarborough, 47. Hunter Revis, 84, with a big block. First down and 10. Give to Woods. He jumps outside. Gain of a couple of yards for Ladarius.
Well, way to run Ladarius, and not a lot there, and he did the best he could. That was a pretty good run for what he had.
Love that. Look at David Ross. Focus in on him, guys. That's a good shot. Alabama signee. He looks like a big guy, and he is. Big heart.
Tell you what, better than Alabama signee. He's just about the best offensive lineman Homewood ever had.
So it's second down and eight. Straight drop for Hubbard. Looking. He throws it for Hawthorne with a turnaround catch. He's inside the 20. Down inside the 10 to the 8 goes Tim Hawthorne.
Bread and butter right here in Homewood. Hubbard to Hawthorne. You're going to score on us. We're coming back quick, buddy.
They make it look easy. Big, tall, 6'2 receiver, 6'2 quarterback. They both have the height to see over the offensive lineman. Defensive line throws a strike. He's in the open area. They had a cover two. Gets some yaks, yards after the catch. Big time plays by big time players.
First down goal to go. Keeper by Hubbard. He's going to get inside to about the six.
Good ball, Halen. Every time he stopped like that, I thought Freeman had it, but he's got enough speed. He turns that corner and picks up some yards.
There is Freeman. I was watching the play fake to him. Good block, Austin.
Nice block by Steve Freeman, Will Cole, and Tim Hawthorne with nice blocks. So a gain of about three on first down. Second and goal at the six. Double tight end set. Straight give to Freeman, and he's untouched again.
Double deuce, I'll say it this time. That's two touchdowns for the big man, and beautiful blocking up the middle. Again, you're playing touch football. He's untouched. Look at this beautiful hole right up the gut.
And you know what makes a great runner? Class. And you know why he's classy? He gives that ball right back to the ref like it's been there before.
He has been there before.
No showboating there. Way to go, Steve Freeman.
So, Hayes on to attempt the extra point once again. Hayes with a nice strong kick, and his third one's good. The Patriots out 21-6.
I tell you, another beautiful drive of the Patriot offense. 3 for 3 out there tonight, and they are moving that ball.
21-6.
See if we can watch the replay one more time. Somebody had a knockdown block in the end zone. See if we can figure out who it was.
Yeah, Hawthorne out there blocking. There you go.
Wow. Just nice blocking up front. And by what you say, the whole offensive line pushing them back. And we got a timeout on the field. Let's take a timeout and listen to our friends at Dawson Memorial Baptist Church.
If you were given a gift that could change the world, how far would you go to share it? With those nearest to you? All around the city? Across the country? Or even to the ends of the earth? Let us know how we can share the gift of God's love with you. Join us this Sunday at Dawson.
Well, back to the game. Appreciate our friends at Dawson Memorial Baptist Church. Dr. Fenton was a great shot of our leader, Bob Newton.
Good-looking shot. I love that old center Patriot there, Tim. It kind of hits me right there in the heart being the center.
Kind of looks like you, Jody.
Good-looking boy right there. That's a good-looking emblem.
Tell you what, it's been mighty lucky. I think it's more than just luck involved, though, guys. What do you think?
That takes you out of the equation then, Jody, if it's luck.
I'm not lucky. But when you get SEC coaches here, the whole coaching staff, watching your players and your team, that's a tribute to the coaching staff. So, way to go, guys.
There's a great shot of Latta Johnson, offensive line coach.
Tell you what, that's Steve Freeman's 27th touchdown of the season. And I'll tell you what, yeah, let's watch that one more time, Glenn. A beautiful hole right up the middle. And the offensive line, it's the best offensive line we probably ever had. And this is their best game. So just keep on keeping on.
Ross with a nice block. All of them. All five. Bodine, Jarvis King, Daniel Mathingani, David Ross, Wilson Boardman, Tim Hawthorne in at tight end, Michael Thompson. And Matt Rebels, what a great offensive front.
You're right, and Tim Hawthorne having a pretty good night. 5 catches, 75 yards, a couple of them very nice receptions there.
Here's Daniel Hayes going to do that sky kick, Larry. We swap sides of the field. Let's see what happens here. Keep our lanes.
The Patriots go 4 plays, 49 yards, minute 15 seconds, and a 6-yard touchdown bolt from the double deuce, Steve Freeman. High kick. Going to come down about the 17. Got the catch. Scott Lee with the tackle.
Scott Lee going to have nothing to do with this return stuff, guys. He smacks that guy about the 23-yard line. Way to play, Scott Lee.
First one down the field, more often than not, guys, all year long on kickoff coverage. And Scott, boom, nice to see you. You know, some of these guys may be their last football game, Larry, so they're laying it out on the line. And here we go, see what happens. Good shot, Scott Lee.
Great camera work by the crew. First down and 10. There's a give going around. Whoa! Hit a train there.
Holy smokes. Let's watch and see the number on that bus. Was it a 6 or a 51?
Coming off tackle. Bam! Who was that? 6.
Michael Oliver. Hello.
I need an extra tooth, Larry. I lost one right back here, and I think
What's
I got
the name
one.
Of this Super 6? Way
That's
to go,
right.
Michael Oliver.
There he is, the Super 6, Michael Oliver for the Patriots. Second down and about 8. Straight give. He jumps it outside. Galbraith grabs him and hangs on. Kenny Baker coming up.
Speed, speed, speed. They will not run outside on us, and you almost feel sorry for them. No, I don't. Way to go, Stan.
No, let's don't feel too sorry. They got the big guy in the game again here. Let's see if they go for that big pass. 18's back in. Let's see if they throw to him.
Well, if they can get to halftime, they got to figure out a way to block number 50 because nobody's blocked him yet.
Here comes 18 wide this side.
Third down and about 6. Looking this way. He's got failed. He throws it short. DJ's there, but it goes incomplete.
Good, great play by DJ. Pressure, pressure, pressure. And the good pressure by failed to hurry that pass. Almost got him another sack, guys.
Best defense against number 18 is let failed go in there and knock the quarterback down, and you don't have to worry about it.
Fourth down and 6. Robbins back at about the 42.
Good shot of that defensive. Watch it. Boom.
Coming up the middle. Oh, we almost got that one. Robbins with a fair catch at the 44. Wow.
Nice no call by the referee. As we went by the guy, he goes down. He's looking for that Oscar, but we'd already handed that out earlier in the season. And that was a, it was 22-6. So how about a 28-yard punt, no return. Good play.
Coach Jones calling them out there, Tim. Sending them out.
Coach Gann, the receiver coach. Coach Jones, offensive coordinator. First down and 10. Ball's at the 44. Double receivers each side. Robbins in motion. Hubbard rolling to the near side. Out to Boardman. Boardman with a catch in midfield and gets a couple of more.
A lot of weapons. We've talked about it all year. A lot of weapons. Big old 6'3 Boardman out here by himself, and let's just go to him. And Hubbard can deliver the ball like nobody I've ever seen, and he puts it right to him. Good play.
Number 80, Brandon Polk, the senior in the game for the Patriots. One more of those many weapons the Patriots have. Double receivers each side. Freeman in the backfield with Hubbard. There's a straight give. He's got the first down to the 44.
Keeping them honest, guys. We got to keep it, you know, belly play up the middle. I like a hurry-up offense. Got that tempo going. We're wearing that defense down. They are sucking wind right now.
Well, David Jones has got the rhythm calling these plays, but I'll be honest with you, when the offensive line is blocking like they are blocking, David Jones is going to have the rhythm.
First down and 10. Hubbard with a keeper. He's going to get a couple down to about the 43, 42.
Austin's pretty fast, but I like Steve running that ball better a little bit. I get nervous when Austin has it. It's an integral part of the offense. Don't need him hurt.
Buckhorn hadn't given up a whole lot of points this year, especially in the playoff. Very stingy. And the Patriots right now are shredding them. Let's see if we've got a second down and 9.
Well, 3 for 3 on offense so far. Come on, Patriots. Let's go. Empty backfield.
Woods, Hawthorne and Polk to the near side. Freeman and Boardman to the far side. Looking for a blitz. Timeout by the Patriots.
No, delay a game penalty. We got a delay a game penalty. Let's hear the call. See if we got timeout or a delay. They're waving the flag off. We got a timeout, Homewood.
So we got a timeout. And did you ride the red wagon down here, Jody?
Well, if I don't ride it today, I'll probably ride in that Christmas parade tomorrow there, Tim. There is Miss Melissa White and Lori Zuko for Buddy Wade. There's Miss Lori. They have been underwriting insurance for everybody in Homewood. There's Buddy himself. And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there, and you're not going to get a better neighbor than Buddy Wade. What an asset. He's here tonight. Seen him, 942-4444. Give him a holler. He'll hook you up.
Appreciate Buddy Wade. We appreciate State Farm Insurance. It's a great shot of the offensive huddle.
How good are they, guys? David Jones, Doug Ginn, Latta Johnson, and Bob Newton, four offensive minds. And they're all four razor sharp and work together and put together they come out with the best offense around.
Four guys work as one mind, and that's why they're so successful here at Homewood.
And one mind and many, many hours of hard work, guys. They're there on Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, of course Friday. They probably do 80-hour weeks for 15 weeks in
more
summer.
Unbelievable. Most impressive part about that is you knew all the days of the week, Jody. I'm impressed. Congratulations. And in order, too.
Well.
Never cease to amaze us, Jody.
And now I'm looking. He's got some little crib notes in his back pocket here. Well, he read that.
Well, they all have that number 11 on their bicep. I have the days of the week and the times.
Good comeback.
Well, the Patriot offense fixing to go back on the field. It's going to be second down and 9 for the Patriots.
Hey, these TV timeouts, but people at Homewood don't appreciate us, see, and we don't even cause these long delays.
Here we go.
Y'all have TV timeouts at Sherbrooke Circle, Jody?
We don't own TVs on Sherbrooke Circle.
That's what I was getting to. Back to live action. Trips to the near side. Double receivers to the far side. Straight drop for Hubbard. Pump fake. Looking over the middle for Robbins. It's high.
Interference. Good play. He got there a little early, and he flipped Tyler. And Tyler, buddy, that was a great try for the ball, and I'm glad you didn't get hurt.
Yeah, Tyler sacrificing his body all day long for Austin to get that ball off, guys. Great protection. Plants his foot, throws a strike. He got him there early. Good call.
Defensive pass interference is going to be 15 yards and automatic first down.
Well, they don't agree on the other side, but the 15-yard penalty on the Bucks. We'll move the ball down to about the 28-yard line for the Patriots. First down and 10. Double tight end set. Flag on the play.
Got an offside. Let's see which way it's going. Buckhorn. Well, it's almost about time for an unsportsmanlike on the far side bench here. They're going a little ballistic over here, so let's wait and see. An unbiased Mitch Nelson says it's the best officiated game he's seen this year.
Hey, we got 8 minutes to go before half. He'll change his mind for the night's out. First down and 5, double tight end set. Give to Freeman. He's got the first. down to the 15.
Nice blocking, beautiful run, and way to go, Steve Freeman.
Look at that. He's a bull. Good shot. I like that O-line shot. Watch him. Bam. Getting up there, good 9-yard gain. And hold on that ball. Don't stretch it out. You get that first down, big boy.
First down. Ball's at the 15. Double tight ends. Looking for Hawthorne in the middle. Wow, what a play. What a throw and what a kick.
Wow, what a catch and what a rifle shot of an arm. This is about a 95-mile-an-hour fastball right here. Let's watch this again. Austin Hubbard, man. Look at that. I mean, that ball doesn't drop one inch in all that distance. And Hawthorne, great catch to catch a fastball like that.
Hubbard to Hawthorne. I'm going to miss saying that next year, guys. It has been such a habit and a great honor to say it. Congratulations.
Hayes on the attempt, his fourth extra point. Kick is up and good. Scott Lee with your hold there and fell with a snap. The Patriots 28-6 lead, 7:48 to play here before half.
You know, that's unreal. 7:48 to go in the half and 28 points for Homewood and none of it off of defense. Let's watch this again. Pretty good blocking and get a little bit of a rush in his face. My goodness, so that I can't tell you how fast that ball's going. And Hawthorne, terrific job to catch it.
And that is the sixth touchdown for Mr. Trey, number three for the year. Number six touchdown for Timmy. Way to go.
You know, every time he catches a football, he's breaking his own record further and further up in there. And I think he's got, what, 7 or 8 for the night now.
5 plays, 56 yards, minute, 34 seconds, and a 15-yard touchdown strike. Hubbard to Hawthorne. There they are, the Homewood High School Patriot Band.
Going to see them tomorrow at the Christmas parade there, Tim. Everybody
we're
going to
see them
there
in about 7 minutes and 48 seconds here at halftime. And so Daniel Hayes on the kickoff. With a long kick. Ball down to about the 10. Running their lanes. Galbraith. Causey. Maybe Daniel Clements, I think, with the first tackle. See if we can watch that again.
Great hustle downfield by 51 and Michael Causey. Everybody stayed in their lanes. We kicked it a little deeper. A true kickoff. Good coverage. Boom. We're going to stand
doing
and Michael
what I
Causey.
Like, going sideways and Stan just lines them up and takes his best shot at them. Good job.
So the ball's out at about the 21-yard line. First and 10 for the Bucks. Keeper. They're stretching it to the far side. Gain of about a yard.
What an effective offensive call. Let's run it wide with. We hadn't ran all night, but David Green, great defensive play. Let's watch this. Our defensive end just kills the tackle, failed, does that. Stan gets out there, and Green, and Kenny Baker, Daniel Hayes. Man.
When you're running vertically against this bunch, you're in trouble. Gain of 1, 2nd and 9. There's a straight give. Dominic Porter. Cordarius Rogers, Robert Gentry all in there.
Good shot. Watch that defensive line explode off. Bam.
Dominic Porter. Wow.
See if you can get that shot the whole time next time, Glenn. That defensive line coming off, just killing them. Love it.
So about 3rd down and 8 for the Bucks.
Tell you, the defensive line penetration is huge, and they don't have a chance in their backfield.
Next time.
Well, we're going to have a timeout, Buckhorn.
Well, we got a timeout, and 6:30 to play. Patriots up 28-6 here in the state championship game 2005. Let's take a little break and listen to our friends at Bite Size Computers. Nice snap from Failed. Catches it about the 15.
Hold it. It's the playoff season, which means it's the holiday season. At Bite Size, we can help. A new flat panel monitor or laptop would look great under the tree. Upgrade to a DVD burner or increase your speed with more RAM. For the holidays, think bite size. Serving Homewood for 20 years. Go Patriots!
Here's a great shot of the Patriot. Patriots right there. Drum Majors. We're going to get some offensive stats from Mitch Nelson right quick.
Very impressive first half so far. Homewood's run the ball 12 times for 93 yards. Austin is 11 of 12 for 132 yards. Steve Freeman's carried the ball 7 times for 80 yards.
Appreciate it, Mitch. Fixing to be back in live action. Third down and 8 for the Bucks. Same formation for the Bucks. He's going to give with a big hole, and he's going to get the first, I think. Nice effort by the tailback.
David Green tripped him up, and he just fell for that first down, I believe. But we almost had him back in the backfield. Hurricane Dorsey in the game, big 47. Young junior.
I can't figure out what all the markings on the guy's arms are. Did you go take a color class?
They had a geometry exam this morning before the pep rally, and everybody had to write the answers down on there.
First down and 10. Ball's all the way out to the 34. Straight drop. He's going to throw long. Kenny Baker with great coverage, and he almost makes the play.
That's pretty close to offensive pass interference. Wasn't intentional, but he drove Kenny away from the ball there, but it was incidental and accidental.
Great coverage there. Kenny Baker, step for step, actually in a better position, and that was close to offensive pass interference.
That's their second attempt to throw, is that right? So it's going to be second down and 10, ball 34-yard line.
Big 18 split by himself on this side.
Scott Lee with coverage. Michael Oliver over the top. There's a straight give. He breaks the tackle. Scott Lee, Stan Galbraith.
Got to lock up. Some big hits being passed. But there you go. Scott Lee, Stan. Hurricane put a hurt on him. That was a Category 3 hit.
Well, the last lick is by Michael Oliver. And I'm going to tell you, every time Michael Oliver's come up and delivered a lick, they go backwards. Michael's playing a pretty good game.
Third down, about 7. 5 minutes, 16 and counting before half. Patriots up 28-6. Straight drop. He's going to throw the quick out. And he's going to – Dorsey runs him out of bounds. He didn't get the first down. So it's going to be fourth and short right here.
Good play by Stan, forcing him back inside, and Dorsey finished it up. Stan could have over-pursued and gone upfield, stayed at home, and what a go.
This is going to be the most interesting call of the night. It's fourth down and about, 1.5? And on their own 42-yard line, they should punt with 5:02 to go, but they're scared to give it back to our offense, so I believe they're going to go for it.
They've gone for it once and made it. Fourth and short again. They're going to take a timeout. There is be their third one of the half, so they'll be out of timeouts. And 5 minutes.
Wait a minute, they're waving
seconds.
Them back on the field? No, timeout. I'm sorry.
Okay, 5 minutes, 2 seconds. 28-6 Patriot lead. Let's take a break. Listen to our friends at Wachovia Bank.
What can saving for college teach us about financial decisions?
Honey, can we fly this year?
Nope. College fund.
Hey, guess what? I got a bonus.
This is great.
College fund.
Yeah.
I got the scholarship.
Plan B.
Wherever you are financially, we're right there with you. Talk to a Wachovia advisor today.
Wachovia Bank, and we appreciate their fine friends at Wachovia Bank. Let's, Steve, fill us in on, give us some highlights of the first half so far by our fabulous defense.
Typical half by the defense. Michael Oliver's got 3 so far. Scott Lee with 3. David the Hitman Green with 4. Aaron Seckfeld with four. Robert Wildman Gentry with eight. Stan the Man with eight. So big half so far.
Possession down for the Bucks. Out of timeouts, 5 minutes, 2 seconds to play in the half. Fourth and one, straight give. And second effort might have got it.
I don't know, it's pretty close. This is going, they're gonna measure this one, guys. I'll tell you right, this is gonna be close.
Yeah, I think he's short. Aaron got back there, stopped his momentum. Sam Berry finished him up. Let's see, game of inches. Let's see what happens here.
I think he's short too.
Got a little timeout. Let's watch the measurement of the gain right here. It's going to be tight. And a great shot of Sam Berry, 42 junior. Here come the chains across the field.
He's going to get it.
Well, he's got a first down. So another conversion on fourth by the Bucks. So it's going to be first down and 10. Ball's at the 44-yard line. They'll take the chains back across the field, reset them. Maybe need to do a little better job of straightening them out. What do you think?
I tell you, that's a tough decision for a coach to have to make there. But, I mean, he made the right one. They made it.
First down and 10 for the Bucks. Straight give again. He jumps outside. Back in, Dominique. Robert Gentry along with Stan Galbraith.
Jailbreak.
Aaron Fell turns them in. Let's see if we can watch that again. What a nice play by our defense.
Here we go. A bunch of red jerseys coming through there. Failed, stands him up, takes on two blockers, makes a tackle. Then Dominique comes around. Gentry.
Dominique first, along with Gentry.
Watch this line. Focus up on that line, guys. Watch these guys. Come on.
Second down and about 12. There's a keeper by the quarterback. He's going to get a lick.
Ouch.
Cordarius Rogers, Michael Oliver. Who's at the bottom of the pile right there? Oh, yeah, DJ Taylor.
Unbelievable. It's almost not fair, guys, how quick we are and how strong we are. Really.
Well, this is like a defensive clinic. And, you know, the only chance they got, that I would throw high on the outside to number 18. Let's watch, see where he lines up, see what we get.
Gain of about almost two, so it'll be a long 10. Third and a long 10 for the Bucks. Straight drop. Throw the slant.
There you go. Hurricane! Woo! Way to go.
36-yard line.
Way to go, Hurricane Dorsey. Welcome to Homewood, big boy. Wow. Way to go, 47.
47, Kenneth Dorsey. And Hurricane has got some hands on him. And, boy, a lot of faking right there. He said, you want to take me on? Come on, big boy. He ran right over that guy.
Not a huge play by the junior, Kenneth Dorsey. First down and 10, ball's at the 36. Give to Freeman in a big hole again. He gets to the outside, he's gonna score.
Double loose.
Get in there.
Yeah, baby, woo!
He's got it, got on the pile. Steve Freeman with a touchdown run of 36 yards.
Wow, what a beautiful touchdown run and beautiful blocking.
Nice job of officiating right there, getting downfield and getting the right angle.
Let's watch this again. Nice blocking, but what a cut here. Boom, he just cuts outside. Oh, my goodness, and he leaves them in a cloud of dust. Freeman is playing the game of his life. Third touchdown of the night.
So a big play from Steve Freeman. Nice blocking up front. Daniel Hayes on the attempt. Scott Lee with your hole. There's a nice hold and a nice kick.
28
the Patriots
touchdowns.
Go up 35-6.
28 touchdowns on the year for Mr. Freeman. Unbelievable. What speed.
Watch this. Matt Rabel springs him.
Got that one more time, Glenn?
We might want to watch that just one more time. Let's watch it again. And we're going to wall them off inside. Look at King. Jarvis King takes him inside, walls him off, and that cut is dynamite because those two guys are just locked up and can't go. One play, 36 yards and 11 seconds. Beautiful, beautiful play.
Number three by the Double Deuce for the night. There's a great shot of our kickoff team. Boy, they've been busy tonight, hadn't they, Jody?
That's why I love that kickoff coverage. It means we're scoring them points and ramming it down the throat. Woo! Hey, Buckhorn's already, they're leaving. They're going to North Alabama already.
They're hanging in there. They're hanging over there.
You know what? The only way we can make this better for Jody Brandt is make him king or something. We need to crown you, Jody.
Somebody says they have already, Larry.
Yeah, I think you're right.
The haze is
on. At Burger King, or where do you get that?
Whopper special. Whopper with
haze
extra
with
onions.
Kick. Going to kick it down to about the 12. Coming up the far sideline. He's going to be tackled by number 8, Jeff McLean.
Beautiful kickoff coverage.
Him and Daniel Clements with the tackle. The sophomore, number 33, Daniel Clements.
All right, this is going to be interesting to see what Buckhorn does, Larry. I think they're obviously in a throw-in frame of mind. They've got to. I mean, throw in the game plan you came in with and put it up in the air. See what these DBs do.
First down and 10, ball at the 28. There's a give.
Whoa!
Dominic Porter with the first lick. Stand the man. Aaron failed. Robert Gentry.
Yep, great play there. Cordero is coming up a little light on that ankle. Let's see what happens here. Dominique in there just blows it up. And it's Cordero. Hope he's okay. Is he still out there? Yeah, he's got some weight on it. Fight through it, big 6'8".
2:25 and running here in the first half. Patriots up big, 35-6. Straight give, gonna get 3 or 4 yards.
Hey, Larry, if you're an offensive center, I think you're supposed to block number 50, not let him come in there, but Robert's just killing him.
He's so quick, and the pulling guard, he stuffs him. I'm gonna tell you, Robert Gentry is a man.
He's coming on. He maybe didn't hear his name as much as he wanted to the last few weeks, but he's been there and showing up big time tonight. Way to go, 5-0.
Well, if you got a double team one of them, you're in trouble.
Yep.
Third down and 6. Minute and 33. Straight drop. Pump fake. He's got a little time. He's flushed by Porter, and he's going down.
87. There you go, Jim and Nix. He's going to get some more barbecue this week playing like that. Way to go, Dominique.
The Dominator, another sack for him. Good play, Dominique. And, you know, he held the sack record last year with 13, and, of course, it's broken by Fell this year. But beautiful play, Dominic Porter.
A great shot of the senior, Dominic Porter. What a nice play that was.
5 tackles tonight, solo, Tim, for Dominic.
Got a timeout by the Patriots with a minute and 22 remaining in the half. Maybe 35 is not enough.
Yeah, I think we're going to go for the record. Our record, I believe, is 42 points and a half, and we got a chance here. So let's just stay here and watch the defensive huddle here and see what we do.
If we score more than 42, Larry, I'm doing push-ups with the cheerleaders tonight.
You've lied all year, and I know you can't do push-ups, so there's another one.
Well, we almost got the last punt. I believe we'll be coming after this one. We may be setting up the return finally.
I'll tell you how impressive this is. Miss Nelson talking about getting a striped shirt, going out and buying a new shirt for Christmas.
Guys, players on the Homewood team, we're so proud of y'all. Y'all are doing great. This crowd, Larry, I've been to a lot of Super 6. This is the biggest Homewood crowd ever. There's old coaches that have come up from Mobile area, college coaches here, grandmas, great-grandparents, teachers, everybody.
Go.
Fourth down, about 7. Punt formation. He gets it off quick and off the side of his foot. It's going to take a hop, and it's going to roll. It'll take a buck roll down to the 31.
38-yard punt, no return, and a smart play by Tyler Robbins. You know what? Anything Tyler Robbins does, it's smart. So good play. Get away from it with a 35-6 lead. Don't take a chance on trying to scoop one up. Good play, Tyler.
Yeah, good coaching, good thinking. That's because he's a good Auburn fan, Larry. That's why he does everything right. Let's go, Homewood.
So a minute 11 remaining here in the half. Austin Hubbard, along with Woods, give to Woods. He's hit in the backfield. He's going to lose about six or seven.
Well, they stunted right into our zone block in there, guys. That defense went slanted right into the play. So one out of 30 isn't bad for them.
54 seconds to go in the first half. Let's see what we do.
Second and about 14. Pump fake. Andrew Jackson deep. He went up the fence down at the 31.
Beautiful play, Andrew Jackson. All the speed and great ability to catch the ball. And let's watch this again.
Wide open. It was there last week, too. But Andrew came in a little cold off the bench. But he was there tonight. And keep your feet moving. It's hard to see that ball when he's standing still. Way to go, Andrew.
That was a heck of a catch by number one, the senior, Andrew Jackson. First down and 10. Ball's at the 31. Rolling to the far side is Hubbard. Looking for the out. Ball goes incomplete. So it stops the clock with 29 seconds to play in the half.
Yeah, that's not all bad at all. Stops the clock, 29 seconds to go, and we're down here in scoring range again, so let's see what we can do. We have one timeout left in the half. Buckhorn has none.
First incomplete pass of the game by Austin, Larry.
That is incredible if that's right.
That's the second one.
Second, sorry.
Well, we told you he couldn't count. The second down and 10 for the Patriots. 31, double receivers each side. Straight drop. Looking for Paul.
LBP.
Great catch at about the 17.
And gets out of bounds and stops the clock with 21 seconds. What another rifle shot. This guy has an arm that won't quit. Watch this pass.
Gets time to throw it off his back foot and plant. Boom. Looks like a professional league pitcher to me, Larry.
There's no arc on that football. I'm going to tell you that. Guys, he just throws that. He hums it in there. And if you don't hum it in, it gets intercepted.
There's Justin King, number 66 in. One of the guards. One of the twins. Justin and Jarvis King. What a great job by the offensive front. First down at about the 18. Hubbard rolling. Looking for Hawthorne with a ball goes incomplete. At about the five, so 16 seconds remaining in the half.
You don't see that much, but a nice play. Good blocking up there, and Austin rolls out and does a good job, and that's okay. That's going to happen once in a while.
Looking for the play from the sideline. Play clock will start. The ball's at the 18, second and 10. Looking for BP, and he throws it out. 11 seconds remaining in the half.
I tell you what, 53 broke through, good pressure, and Austin had to get rid of that and threw it up in the cheap seats there, and he did that on purpose just to avoid a sack. Good play, Austin.
Let me watch Utah or draw here, Larry.
Third down and 10, trips to the far side. We got to run the draw back this way to Woods. He's going to be tackled.
Timeout.
2 seconds remaining in the half. Timeout by the Patriots. Woods gets it down to about the 14.
Well, the initial hit was by somebody with a white shirt on, but the umpire, biggest man out there, he gets an assist on that.
I'd say that's a big, big man right there.
Trucks, write that down. Assist by the umpire.
Vince doesn't even have a comment on that.
Cancel that striped shirt order.
Watch that replay one more time.
Every football game you watch, every single football game you watch, the biggest official is going to be the umpire.
Now, here we go.
Because they can't move. Well, we're fishing for the right play, but at any rate, you're going to see the umpire make the lick if you get it. That's all right. We don't have it. We don't really need it. Ball's on the 14. If we kick a field goal, it'll be from the 21, which will be a 31-yard effort.
Daniel Hayes is good for it, guys. Inside the 39, he's Mr. Automatic.
Hayes is on to attempt the field goal. 2 seconds remaining in the half. Ball's at the 14. 31-yard attempt from the senior, Scott Lee. With your hole, Aaron Feld, will you snap?
That's air.
He's got it. Daniel Hayes with a big kick to end the first half. 38-6 Patriot lead.
And that is the best half of football, the best Homewood football team we've ever had, ever played right there.
Yeah. 8 out of 11 for Daniel Hayes on the year. Inside the 39, he does not miss. Way to go, Daniel.
He nails this, and he kicks it on through probably by 15 yards. It hits the fence way behind the goalpost. That's way good.
Daniel, you've come a long way since that Shades Valley game, big boy. I'll never forget that first field goal attempt, and doing good.
Nice job.
Well, that's the end of the half. Patriots up big, 38-6, state championship game, 2005. We're going to come down, and then we'll come back and film the Patriot band, and then we'll see you at the start of the second half.